How y'all doing tonight?
Great.
So my story tonight is one of the five times that I've been arrested because of my disability of being as far as, along with a little help from my Tourettes Syndrome. So it was Friday night. Had a pretty good intense workout at the gym. I was leaving my gym just like any other night, walking to my car, get in, put the seat, start the music, drive off. And this was the time I was living in Minnesota. Really, really small town. So I drive off in this police car. I hear that. Pulls me over. Cop comes in, really small-minded, small town police officer with a god-awful Minnesota accent. So I don't know. I'm really used to it, so I don't know if y'all are really used to it at all, but it sounded a little bit like this.
In here, but you know, it's here doing a little swerving gear in your car here. Why don't you tell me about the movie, don't you?
And here's a little backstory about myself. There's a lot of different kind of Tourette's and a lot of different tics that set off anxiety and spasms, of course. Mine is caffeine and anxiety stress situations. So one, I just left the gym with a really good workout filled with caffeine. And a cop just pulled me over and said I was swerving. So, like, a conundrum of horrible events that just happened to make my tits worse within a matter of 3 minutes. Do y'all remember, like, Pokemon growing up at all?
Yeah.
Tourette's just evolved into Tourette's 2.0. Yeah, it's pretty bad. So he comes up and he taps me and he said, "Hey, you're about it. I noticed you're doing a little serpent here. Why don't you, tell me about it?" And I told him, like, "Well, dog, I have a disability, like, I have Tourette's. You know, I have the verbal noises and I have the movement tics." And he comes up and, now this is when the story begins. He laughs and said, "Oh, you look at Tourette's. What do you think, are you still at the back of the turnip truck now, don't you, bud? Get out of the car and we're gonna do some brain tests on you." Now at that time I had a small conversation with a really dark side of my mind. I said, "I think I should really cooperate with this guy. He's pretty serious." And my brain said, "Go to jail." Messing with him. I was like, "All right, I'll go. No one else is here to tell me their thing, so." So starting off with what I said, he said, "You don't have Tourette's syndrome." I was like, "Excuse me?" He said, you're just fooling me. You don't have Tourette's." So I opened my car door a little bit. I get on my knees and I caress his hand in a really public area. And I yell, "Thank you, Jesus Christ, I'm cured! Oh my God! Who knew this whole time that I was faking it? Thank you so much! Medical professionals everywhere will just be astounded by this discovery. Thank you!" And he threw me on the ground and arrested me that Friday night. That was the first time I ever went to jail. It was really interesting because I had to stay there Saturday and Sunday. Saturday was a little boring, and it was a small community, so it was a co-op jail. So people coming out, in and out. Sunday night, I met this really, she is honestly my best friend now, but it was really awkward at the time because I'll ask questions without really thinking about it. So she comes in, she's looking at me like I'm like high or something. Can you imagine that? She looks at me and says, "What are you in here for?" I told her, "Being retarded." I said, "What are you in here for?" She said, "Well, I tried to kill myself." I was like, "Wow, that's deep. Like, why would you want to do that?" She said, "Well, you know, I'm tired of living life. Like, every time I complete a goal, my mind said, well, why didn't I do a second one?" I was like, "Wow, I felt that." So I asked her, not really thinking of anything, "So, how did you, like, try and do it?" She said, "Well, I took a bunch of sleeping pills and, you know, it just went from there." And I was like, "Okay, well, numbers-wise, I'm curious, like, how many pills does it really take to do that?" She said, "Not 24. She's doing good, all right. I still talk to her. She has a family now. I'm so blessed that I met her, that opportunity. So anyway, Monday comes along.
Finally, I went to see the judge. He calls me up, he's like, all right, case number 76509-numbers, whatever. And I step forward and he's like, all right, well, it looks like you were arrested here for assaulting an officer, resisting arrest, and driving while under the influence. How do you plead? I said, not guilty. Here's my doctor's number. I go golfing with him every other week. He can prove that I actually have this disability. So he calls the guy, confirms it. Oh, hey, I haven't seen you since row 3 or what? Like, they know each other, obviously. And so he says to the officer, all right, well, looks like this is actually a misunderstanding. Why don't you apologize for the nice disabled dog over there, and we'll just go on our way. I was like, no, I know this with him now. This isn't enough. So I looked at him, I said, sir, this is ridiculous. Like, what if this happens to the next person and he wins like a multi-million dollar lawsuit? I mean, I'm only here for a minute, but I at least want an identification card so I can, like, be labeled as a disabled person in case this happens again. He's like, all right, well, you know, I guess that's fair. Here, laminated, crown, here you go. Have a good day. So I leave, and I was like, all right, I got this. Let's test this puppy out. So I leave the courthouse and I go up and really abandon. I go up and abandon one way, and not that cop, same cop pulls me over and taps somebody and he's like, hey, bud, you just literally went to the courthouse like 8 minutes ago. Like, what's the deal? You know you can't drive up this one way. It's like, sir, it's alright. I'm retarded. Alright, thank you everyone. Next time.